Okay?
But ideally, I want to keep my weight forward. Come up, keep my weight forward. Okay? It's going to look like this.
You got one hand. Let's say you punch the guy, you strike him, and he's got hold of your hand. You can't use your secondary hand support hand to get the gun. So now you've got to deal with one hand. It's going to look something like this. Up. So how would I deal with it? It's happening, rapid. And as you see, it got that casing out. Now, people say to me, well, what happens if I put my thumb behind the slide? I'm going to lose my thumb. Well, yeah, if your thumb's back here and it gets momentum, the inertia's going to hurt. But if you notice, I can take any police caliber gun. I don't care if 357 SIG. I don't care if it's a 10 millimeter. I don't care what it is. I can put my thumb behind it. And nothing's going to happen. So now I'm out of battery. That racket. So if I had to do a contact shot, if I drive the gun into the target, now this is paper, I can send it out of battery, it's not going to function. So if it's a contact shot, I need the gun to function, I'm going to punch it in. Step back, that racket. Okay? So, not necessarily ideal, but if you got to do it, it's not going to hurt you. It's good to know that it won't break your thumb. Right here, I'm just basically going to hit it. More than the trigger. I'm not so much worried about my sights now as I am just holding up left at my target and giving it the death grip. If you watch, this is a nice vertical track instead of a horizontal all over the place. So you've got to really squeeze that gun around for this type of activity. Now,